So welcome back. We have clay that has been glazed, but as you can see, the color is not quite right. So it's time for its second firing in the kiln. So when we load our tiles in the kiln, we want to make sure that there is no glaze on the back, that it is completely plain, and that things don't touch once they're inside. Otherwise, the glaze acts like glue and everything sticks together, and that makes for one big disaster. All right, and so now that I've got one level in, it's time to add a shelf and keep filling it on up. When we do a load in the kiln, we always want to make sure that we have a full load. Mom doesn't do laundry with just a pair of socks. She does it with a whole basket full, and the same is for the kiln. It has to be full all the way to the top. All right, now that we have the kiln loaded as full as we can go, because I ran out of shelves, it's time to close the lid and turn it on. So to make sure it fires right, I gotta fill out a whole bunch of buttons over here, and then she'll start up ready to go. There she goes. We'll see you in the morning to see what it turns out like. All right, so we are back to open the kiln to see how our pottery turned out with all their glaze. So as you can see, the colors have changed. Everything has a nice shine to it. And that's what the kiln does for our glaze when we're all done. And as you can see, this is a tile that was just glazed but not fired. And that's how it transforms once it's heated up to almost 2,000 degrees.